Hey everyone out there, I want to take you on a journey, a little church history, very interesting church history, and then I want to ask you some very personal questions. If you look at Christianity, Christianity started in Israel as a body of believers who was led by the Holy Spirit, who was preaching the gospel, who was healing the sick, who was casting out demons. People repented, got baptized water, received the Holy Spirit. They experienced persecution, but they experienced the real life, the life we read about in the book of Acts. So it started as a body of believers. Then it came to Greece and became a philosophy. It moved from Greece to Rome and became an institution. It moved from Rome to the rest of Europe and became a culture. And it came overseas to America and became a business, an enterprise. But if you make an enterprise, a business out of a body, then that is prostitution. And this is sadly what we have done today. We have prostituted the body of Christ. And Jesus is not going to come back for a whore, a prostitute. He's going to come back for a beautiful, beautiful, clean bride. Let's look at the church history again. Christianity started in Israel as a body of believers who came together. It was a movement. It was a kingdom they were preaching with a king, Jesus Christ. They have everything in common often. They ate together. They came together daily. They were healing the sick. They were casting out demons. They were preaching the gospel and people repented and got baptized, received the Holy Spirit. And they were living this amazing life together with persecution, because that is part of it. This life we read about in the book of Acts, the real life with Christ, led by the Holy Spirit, supernatural life. But what happened? Christianity changed many places, and it came to Greece and became a philosophy. And this is what it is for many people today. Maybe this is what Christianity is for you. It's just a philosophy. And Jesus, he's a big philosopher, one among many. But Christianity is so much more than a philosophy. And if you see Christianity as a philosophy, one among many, you are deceived. But what happened? It became a philosophy. And then it moved from Greece to Rome and became an institution, the Catholic Church. Out of this, we have the Lutheran Church. We have many churches today where church is an institution, where many look at Christianity as something you go and do in a building Sunday morning, where a priest is the middleman between you and God. You go to a certain place, a holy place with some holy people who do some holy things. And then when you leave that place, you leave God in that building. Many people today see Christianity as just an institution. If you see Christianity as an institution, you are deceived. But then it came from there, from Rome, and it spread all over Europe, and it became a culture. And it was what I grew up in. I grew up in culture Christianity. I got baptized as a baby. I got confirmed. I did what the church told me to do. It was just a culture. I did never go in church like, yeah, when there was a wedding or funeral, because that was what we did. But I was Christian. Why? Because I was Danish. It was part of my culture. 90% at that time got baptized as a baby, or something you did in Denmark, because it was our culture. I was deceived. I grow up thinking that Christianity is like a culture. If this is like you, if you look at Christianity as a culture and not a person, strong personal relationship with God, you are also deceived. Then it moved from Europe to America and became an enterprise, a business, where you are not led by the Holy Spirit, but you are led by the money. And it's all about the money. It's all about getting that business up running. And now I'm in America and I'm shocked. Like, some churches I've seen, it's almost like franchising the way they run it. You run a church today like you run McDonald's or Burger King. It had really many places become a business. And it centers around the money and about getting this business up running. I don't know where you are today, Maybe, because it's not only you can see Christianity as a philosophy and be all over the world today. You can see Christianity as a culture, be all over the world today. You can see Christianity and run it as a business and be all over the world today. It's not only in America it has become a business. I want to say with these words, make sure that Christianity for you is not a culture. Make sure it's not a philosophy. Make sure it's not a business. Make sure that is the real stuff. It's a movement. It's a family. It's a kingdom. It's a body of believers. Make sure that your life looks like the life you read in the book of Acts. That is the real thing before it starts to get destroyed by so many other things. God bless you out there. Don't be deceived like I have been deceived for many years. Don't be deceived. See the truth. Take up your Bible. Read the book of Acts. Read how the early church was living. Look at your life. If your life don't look like the book of Acts, how the early church was living, then there was something wrong. And it's not in the Bible that something wrong is in your life. But I guarantee you, if you repent, if you seek God and start to step out on the word of God, you're going to experience an amazing life like we read in the book of Acts. And it's going to change your life. And you're going to come back to how it was in the beginning. God bless you all out there. Bye-bye.